pastor an old church in the city of Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And I began to deal with an old church. And many of the members are here tonight. But I began to deal with an old church that got away from the old tenets of fasting and praying. And here I came in as a young boy. And I said that we're getting ready to call a shut-in. I had people to tell me that if you have a shut-in, those old folk will not come. If you call a prayer meeting, ain't nobody coming out to prayer. But I want you to know that I called my first shut-in, and the church was packed from the front to the back. And every week, from that day until now, our church gathers together, and we get on our knees, and we pray together, and demons are cast out, and bodies are healed, and souls are delivered, because we are seeking the face of God, and we are teaching people. I've got so many young people, I've got some of them here tonight, that would tell me, Pastor, I'm so glad that a young man told me how to live saved. Nobody ever told me that I had to clean up my life. Nobody ever held me accountable. Nobody ever told me that holiness really did work. But so many people today are delivered because somebody told them. I'm afraid that we're losing something because we're trying to compromise to accommodate people. I've had people to tell me, Pastor, you don't understand, I don't want to lose my son and I don't want to lose my daughter, so I don't want anybody to tell them anything about their sin or about their mess. I'm just glad that they come to church. But I got to tell you in here, my dear brother or sister, that if they have not learned the tenets of our faith and have not learned how to live holy, they might be in the church, but they've already been lost, because you have many in the house and lost. But we need somebody that will lift holiness and righteousness in the house of God. Well, I got to hurry up here now. Here, Peter is talking to a community of people that are Christians. And because of the fact that they have chosen to be holy, because of the fact that they have chosen to be righteous, Bible gives us to know that they were being persecuted. They were going through hard trials and tribulation. Their lives were even being threatened because of their commitment to God. But the Bible said that here Peter, who had been in prison, here Peter, that had been falsely accused, here Peter, that had suffered much persecution for the cause of Christ, went back and told the story to individuals that were struggling and holding on to the faith. He told them, he said, my brethren, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial which has come upon you. It has come not to destroy you, but it has come to try you. It has come to teach you how to engage in relationship with God. It has come to show you that the only way that you can know God is through suffering with him. The only way that you can be what God desires for you to be is you've got to deal with some trials. He said the trial did not come to destroy you, but the trial came to try you. It came to prove you. It came to see what was in your heart. It came to bring you to a place so that you would be partakers in the suffering with Christ, but that you would also be able to rejoice in the glory of the Lord that shall be revealed on the inside of you. Well, I just came to tell somebody in here tonight that what you're going through is not strange. It is not unusual, but God designed it so that it would prove you and so that it would make you into what God desires for you to be. I've got to implore some of the writings of Paul now. I heard it earlier. He said, I reckon that the suffering of this present time shall not be worthy to be compared revealed on the inside of you. I've determined that I made up in my mind that I'm going to keep my mind stayed on the Lord. Peter, he deals with the thought process. He lets the saints of God know that the biggest struggle that you will have is not the battle without, but it's the battle within. The biggest struggle you will have is the fight in your mind. The devil will always try to fight you in your mentality, always try to fight you in your intellect. But we are the saints of God that will realize that this ain't nothing new. For the Bible said that since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. I come to tell you in here, no matter what you're going through, it's time for the saints of God to hold on to the horns of the altar and to stand up and tell the devil he's a liar. Is there anybody here that said the devil knocked me around? He knocked me down a little bit. I've been struggling in my mind. I've been struggling in my emotion. I've been dealing with depression. I've been dealing with problems on my job, problems in my home, problems in my school, problems with my children. But I'm getting ready to get back up and open up my eyes and tell the devil that I'm tired of being tired, and I'm sick of being sick, but I'm getting ready to fight back. I'm fighting for my life. I'm fighting for my peace. I'm fighting for my joy. Well, if you're here tonight and you say, preacher, how in the world do you expect me to deal with emergencies? How in the world do you expect me to deal with problems? I've been crying myself to sleep. I've been worried, pacing the floor, back and forth. How can you tell me not to panic when my boy is in jail? How can you tell me not to panic when I've got sickness in my body? How can you tell me not to panic when all hell is broken loose in my life? Well, I come to tell you that you were made for this. You were called for this. You were qualified for this. And all you gotta do is get a new mind. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus. You can be healed. You can be delivered. You can have the victory. You can overcome. The devil is a bluffer. The devil is a liar. He is a deceiver. No weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you in judgment shall be condemned. You are the righteousness of God. You are a servant of the Lord. God has given you authority over the enemy. Stop letting the devil whoop you around. Behold, I give unto you power over all the power of the adversary. Power to heal the sick. Power to raise the dead. Power to cast the devil out of your mind. I made up in my mind that I'm going all the way with God. This year has been hard for me. It's been rough for me. I've been challenged on every hand. I've been fought from the left and fought from the right. I've been lied on. I've been mistreated. I've been abused. But I got a word in me that said God will see me through my storm, through my trial. I got a word in me that said that this thing is but for a moment, but after I suffer a little while, if I hadn't had to suffer, I wouldn't have learned how to be a man that God wanted me to be. I had to learn how to try my eyes and come out fight. I had to learn how to square my shoulders and come out standing. I'm standing on the word of my God. I'm standing. Is there anybody here?